Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. To my doctor, today I will present for my individual assignment engineering mathematics 2 ECC 3012. My name is Muhammad Asri bin Muhammad Asib and my matric number is 201054. So the topic of my presentation is engineering application of cooling in current carrying components in high voltage power equipment. I will be using Laplace equation and specifically in Poisson equation. So, overview of my presentation. Firstly is introduction, second, engineering problem, third, method and calculation, and lastly, conclusion. So, for the introduction, Laplace equation is a second order partial differential equation. Laplace equation is Laplace when equal to 0, while Poisson's equation is lambda squared equal to fxy. Cooling is important to prevent the circuit from overheating that can cause irreversible damage. So, EHT pump is used easier and more efficient to remove heat. So, for my engineering problem, current carrying components in high voltage equipment must be cooled to carry away the heat caused by ohmic loss. A means of pumping is based on the force transmitted to the cooling fluid by charges in an electric field. The EHD pumping is modeled in the figure. The region between the electrodes contains a uniform charge, rho initial, which is generated at the left electrode and collected at the right electrode. Calculate the pressure of the pump if rho initial is equal to 25 and V initial equal to 22 kilovolt. So this is the figure of my engineering problem. For the boundary conditions, when Z is equal to 0, V is equal to V initial, and when V is equal to D, V is equal to 0. So for the method and calculation, since rho V is not equal to 0, it is considered to apply Poisson equation. So lambda squared times V equal to negative rho V over epsilon. The boundary condition given shows that V depends only on V value. Hence, delta squared V over delta Z squared equal to negative rho initial over epsilon. So by integrating it once, give dV over dz equal to negative rho initial z over epsilon plus a, and integrating it again, V is equal to negative rho initial times z squared over 2 epsilon plus a z and plus b. So to solve the equation for the first boundary condition, and Z is equal to 0, V will be equal to V initial. Therefore, V initial equal to 0 plus 0 plus B. So it gives V equal to V initial. We substitute back into the equation, we will get V equal to negative rho initial times Z squared over 2 epsilon plus AZ and plus V initial. So for our second boundary condition, and Z is equal to Z, D, V is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is equal to negative rho initial times D squared over 2 epsilon plus AD plus V initial. So our A will be rho initial times D over 2 epsilon minus V initial over D. So now, when we substitute it back, the equation is V equal to negative rho initial times x squared over 2 epsilon plus rho times d over 2 epsilon minus v initial over d times x and plus 2 v initial. So the electric field is given by E equal to negative lambda times v. So it will be negative rho initial times x over epsilon minus rho initial times d over 2 epsilon and V initial over D time AZ. The net force is F equal to QT over E. QT is equal to integration of P rho V over DV. We substitute it in F equal to QT times E, and we will get F equal to integration of rho V times E DV. We know that integration of dV is equal to integration of S dz. So the value will be substituted into the equation above. We will get F equal to integration of rho V times E S dz equal to rho initial times S integration E dz equal to rho initial times S time rho initial times z squared over 2 epsilon minus rho initial times dz over 2 epsilon and plus v initial times z over d times z. So f we will get equal to rho initial times z times rho time initial times d squared over 2 epsilon minus rho initial times d squared over 2 epsilon and plus v initial times d over d times s. So we will cancel out the d from the equation and we will get rho initial times s times v initial times s. So pressure, which is force per unit area, is given by f over s when it is equal to rho initial times S times V initial, which is 25 times 10 power of negative 3 times 22 times 10 to the power of 3, and we will get 550 Newton per meter squared. So for the conclusion of my presentation, the Laplace equation, second order partial differential equation, is useful in engineering because its solutions are known as harmonic functions. It occurs in problems of electrical, magnetic, and gravitational potential, of steady state temperature, and of hydrodynamics. Based on the calculation, the pressure of the pump transmitted to the cooling fluid by charges in an electric field is rho initial times S times V initial equal to 550 Newton per meter squared. That's all from me.